Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2245, Streamlining the Bennu Model with Arrays. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, last week at Ignite, John Campbell, one of the Excel project managers, had a session, and here's a quote from John. He said, "We heard from an MVP who replaced 200,000 cells with a single dynamic array formula. Recalc time was cut in half, file size cut by 99%. That is a crazy claim. But the model that he's talking about was my entry in the Excel hash game, Will Asteroid Bennu Impact the Earth? All right. In my original model, I ran 100,000 trials of Asteroid Bennu based on data from NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory. There were 100,000 cells of norm.inverse using RAND, and then 100,000 cells of VLOOKUP, looking up those into the JPL table, and then one sum to track how many impacts there were over 100,000 trials. Then a what if data table ran this whole thing 100 times. That file was 3,270,979 bytes. I was able to replace those 200,001 cells with a single cell that has sum of VLOOKUP of norm.randarray 100,000. That generated 100,000 rand arrays. Everything else the same. What if data table runs the same thing in 100 times? File size 37,723, which is 1.2% of the original size. Now let's take a look at recalc times. All right, here's a stripped down version of the model that I used for Excel hash. These formulas, the norm.inverse of RAND, there's 100,000 of those, and then a VLOOKUP, comma true, that's the fast version, into a tiny table of about 160 rows, all comes up to one sum function of all those VLOOKUPs to figure out the probability of Bennu hitting the Earth in 2182 to 2196. And then over here, a data table that runs that whole model, I think, 100 times. All right, so we'll calculate how long this takes using the original model. And it's 10.8 seconds, 10.8. Click OK, we'll run it again, 10.75, and run again, 10.73. Now, how can we make this faster using the RANDARRAY function? So the first thing we can do is we can take that whole norm.inverse and put it inside the VLOOKUP. And I could have done this before dynamic arrays. That would have cut the 200,000 cells down to 100,000 cells, without a doubt. But then, instead of having 100,000 cells with RAND, I could ask for a RAND array and ask for it to return 100,000 results. It's going to lift the norm.inverse and the VLOOKUP and cause 100,000 of these and 100,000 of these to happen. And I want this all just to come back into a single wrapper function to let me know how many we get. Okay, now, this workbook is still active down to AH 100,000. So let's close and save. All right, we're in a new version of the file, the array version of the file. This time, when I press end home, it's only active down to row 180, and that's because of the lookup table back there. And we will calculate this version. Now, again, this one formula is doing 100,000. RAND array, sending it into norm.inverse, sending that into VLOOKUP. So 100, 200, 300,000 calculations plus 1, 300,000 and 1. We'll calculate. Calculate 5.43. Calculate 5.43. Calculate 5.39. It's faster. It's definitely faster. Now, one interesting thing here that I can't quite explain is one of the reasons that it's faster is because of this data table. If I had taken the data table out, then the recalc times between the original 200,000 cell model and this one cell model are about the same. It's actually a little bit slower in this version. And that's strange because anytime you're using the table function, Excel is forced into single-threaded calculation. So why, being forced back into single-threaded calculation, does this run in half the time of 200,000 cells? I can't quite explain that. Well, these new dynamic arrays are amazing. They'll be coming to Office 365. Make sure not to get Excel 2019. It won't have them. You have to wait till Excel 2022. Check out my new book, Excel Dynamic Arrays, Straight to the Point. Click that I on the top right-hand corner. This book will be free through the end of 2018. Wrap up for today. All right, the forecast model with 100,000 RAND, NORM.INVERSE, VLOOKUP, and one sum replaced with one single formula using RANDARRAY. The average time to calculate 10.76 seconds when it was 200,000 cells, 5.37 seconds, 49% of the recalc time. To download the workbook from today's video, visit the URL in the YouTube description. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.